In this video, I am going to explain anatomy of internal oblique. Internal oblique, which is this muscle. This is part of core muscle. I am going to explain its origin, insertion, and function. Origin is this part. Let me explain that. The part of origin is this part. There is fascia on posterior part of core. This is thoracolumbar fascia. Thoracolumbar fascia, okay, which is fascia on back part of body. Number one, thoracolumbar fascia. Next part is this part. This is iliac crest. Iliac crest. And next one is connective tissue on inguinal area. This is inguinal ligament. Inguinal ligament. So these are origin of internal oblique. Thoracolumbar fascia, iliac crest, and inguinal ligament. Okay, now let me explain insertion of internal oblique. Okay, I changed angle of internal oblique. So let's go to insertion. First one is this part. This is pubis. Pubis, okay? Then this tissue, this is linear alba. Linear alba. Linear means line. Alba means white. So it's white line. This is on midline. Pubis, linear alba, and it attaches on rib 9 through rib 12. Rib 9 through rib 12. Do you remember? Origin was on back side of body, iliac crest, and inguinal ligament. So it's like a posterior part and lateral part. Insertion is here, pubis, linear alba, and rib 9 through rib 12. So it's like midline and lateral part. You see that? Yellow part is insertion. The white part is origin. You see that? This is difference. Anyway, insertion is pubis, linear alba, rib 9 through rib 12. Now let me explain its function. Main function of internal oblique is side bend and rotation. Okay, this is right side of internal oblique. When right side contracts, that goes to right side bend. Okay, side bend and right side rotation. It goes to same way of rotation and side bend. Particularly, if rotation goes same way, that means ipsilateral rotation. Ipsilateral rotation. Ipsilateral means same side. Right side internal oblique, right side rotation, that means ipsilateral. So the other way is contralateral. If, this is if story, okay? If right side of muscle contracts and if that makes left side rotation, that is contralateral rotation, okay? Contralateral. However, internal oblique is ipsilateral, which is same side, okay? Side bend and ipsilateral rotation. One more thing I need to talk about, which is trunk flexion. Trunk flexion. You know, but this is a little bit minor function. main muscle for trunk flexion is rectus abdominis, which is six-pack muscle. So internal oblique does slight flexion, however, it's like a minor muscle for trunk flexion. Main functions are side bend and rotation. Okay, now let me explain relationship with external oblique. This is internal oblique. Internal oblique. This is external oblique. You know, direction of fiber is different between internal oblique and external oblique. This is right side. This is left side. Left side, external oblique. Right side, internal oblique. So, direction kind of matches. Does it make sense? You know what I'm talking about? So, left side external oblique goes this way. Right side internal oblique also goes this way. So, the opposite side external oblique and internal oblique direction kind of matches. This is very important. So, right side internal oblique makes this kind of rotation. And left side external oblique makes this way rotation. This is very, very interesting thing. So, in this video, I explained basic anatomy of internal oblique, its origin, insertion, function, and relationship with external oblique. If you liked today's video, please hit the like button, comment, and subscribe. See you next video.